Hello everyone, this is Razvan. Long time no see. I hope that you and your family are okay and safe in these difficult times. So all the best from my side for everyone. Today I would like to show you a special product. A leather pen pouch, 100% handmade in Romania from a local craftsman. The brand name is Might&Wit, and this particular pen pouch, it's called the Emperor Walnut. So again, 100% handmade from premium vegetable tanned leather sourced from UK. It's a very interesting pen pouch, very well made. I hope that you can see the stitches are very fine, well done. This is the logo, the buffalo of this particular craftsman. Very interesting approach. Let me show you how this works. So we have a long we have a long piece of leather, as you can see, folded in two. And here we have the fountain pens. This is a very interesting leather because it's thin, but not too thin, and also soft on the interior. So this means that if we have, you know, more sensitive, surface sensitive fountain pens, for example like this Black Mamba Bonita L4-in material, then this type of pen pouch can easily protect it. So this is a two pen or fountain pen or two writing instrument pen pouch, and because of this particular design, and I think this is the most useful aspect of it, of course, you can practically fit here almost any type of fountain pen, you know, thicker fountain pens, short, longer, etc. It doesn't matter because, as you can see, it will be able to fit just well. So I have two fountain pens here, the Black Mamba and the Opus 88 Omar transparent, which are big pens, yeah, and this particular pouch can accommodate them without an issue. So we have the stitch on the center just to separate them, and then you introduce the other one, and use this leather string to close it down like that. So, very practical, again, very nice leather. I've been using this for the last 2 months in my backpack. No issues whatsoever. Very well done. And let me show you, let's say I want to exchange one of these. And I have a standard regular Parker Jotter fountain pen. I can slide this in here, fold it, and just close it down. It's a little bit hard, difficult in front of the camera, but you can see. So I have the jotter in here, safely protected, no issues whatsoever. So we have quite a lot of space, both in terms of in the diameter of the pen, as you can see, and also in terms of length, no issues whatsoever. You can fit here 150 millimeters long pens without any type of issues. Also, one, again, because of this particular design, we don't have any, we don't have issues with the clip of the fountain pen. And let me show you what I mean by that. This is a more standard, less expensive, of course, pen pouch. This is a free pen pouch. And I have three fountain pens in here. One of the issues with this particular design is with the clip, because the clip doesn't fit in the interior here. Yeah, there is no room for that. So it should go over on the exterior like that. And then you come with this particular part just to close it down, and you put it like that, and the clip may be in the way. For this particular design, you know, they've enlarged this part, but this may be an issue. Yeah? So the Emperor Walnut doesn't have this type of issues, which is good. Also, another simpler design, also handmade, is this one. Very nice Italian leather, very well crafted as well. This is a thicker leather compared to this one, as you can see. Yeah, it's different, totally different type of leather. The problem with this one, first, we don't have the clip problem with this one, so, because, you know, as you can see, the fountain pen will just slide in. But if you put a larger pen in the beginning, you know, when you just have this this pen sleeve, the leather will take the form of that particular pen. So this means if I remove the stylograph and I insert the jotter, and I will do like that, the jotter will come out very easily, because there is a lot of room in here, as you can see, because the leather took the dimension of the larger fountain pen. So that's the issue with this particular design. This is not happening with the Emperor Walnut. As I've shown you, you just, you know, you have a big fountain pen here. I take the jotter, I'm inserting it in the next compartment, and then I just close it with the string. Yeah, you need to do this particular operation. The string is long enough, as you can see. It's also very well stitched in here, so it is resistant. It is made out of the same leather as the pen pouch, the main pen pouch. And you do it like that, and it's done. Sorry, again, it's difficult in the camera. And you are ready, and no fountain pens will come out. So very, very interesting design, pragmatic, utilitarian, I would say, excellent quality in terms of the leather, soft leather, but also resistant to shocks in the end. Yeah, it's not super resistant, so yeah, you know what I mean. But it's quite nice, and because it's soft in here, in the interior, will protect the surface of the fountain pens much better than other types of leathers. Very well done and polished. This is the bottom part, as you can see. There are no rough edges whatsoever. No tearing, no issues. The price of this particular pen pouch, again, 100% handmade in Romania, is $59, and I think it is worth it. This is a product that can last even a lifetime, or for a long time. This is not a consumer product, that's for sure. I will put the the Facebook page of the manufacturer in the description. They also have a separate site. It's under construction at this moment. But if you want to take a look or if you want to contact them, they are open for international orders. You can go ahead and take a look. Okay, that's pretty much it for today's video. I hope you find this useful. And keep in touch for the next review. Just as a side note from my side, I know I've been a long time away from this particular channel. It's just because I had other projects taking the time, and I want to present you with interesting fountain pens and fountain pens related products. Something that maybe you cannot see in all the other channels that are reviewing fountain pens. It's I'm not hunting subscribers, so yeah, I hope that you are okay with that. I just want to, you know, whatever I present you, to give you as much detail as possible and also to be interesting for you. Yeah, okay, thanks again. And we keep in touch. Goodbye.